Hi folks, welcome to Coffee and Habakkuk on Thursday. It's again tea and Habakkuk, peppermint tea, because I'm still feeling a bit croup. We are looking at verse 12 of chapter 1, and it is phenomenal. It is phenomenal. And so I was preparing some stuff and I realized I'm going to be ages talking about this, so we'll split it into two parts. And let me just read you the first part. Lord, are you not from everlasting? My God, my Holy One, we will never die. Now, this for me is just an extraordinary piece. I think Habakkuk took his time before responding. And then he did something that was brilliant and that we need to use. And for me, it has been the anchor for my life. And what I mean by that is, as Christians, we face difficulties with God's providence. Things are happening. Why did this happen? And we really wrestle with it, and cliches don't help. But instead of allowing the problem to undermine his faith in God, what Habakkuk does is he affirms what he knows. Now, he doesn't know why it's happened. He doesn't know what's going on, but he does know who God is. And so he says that, and let's just reflect on that a bit. Now, the music in the background, sorry, that's on my computer. I'm going to put it off, actually, but that's only a holy God, because that's one of the things that he says. He says that God is holy. And we'll reflect on that more as we go through the chapter, because he's basically saying God can do no wrong. But I think the main emphasis here is on the eternity of God. And he uses the term Yahweh. I think Deuteronomy 33:27, the eternal God is your refuge and underneath of the everlasting arms. Or Psalm 90 verse 1, Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, or you brought forth the whole world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. Now, so Habakkuk is approaching God as the covenant king of his people, and as the one who gets it all. When Hezekiah was doubting, the message he got from God was this: have you not heard? Long ago I ordained it, in days of old I planned it, now I have brought it to pass. So what God is saying is, or what Habakkuk is saying is, look, we're in this tiny sliver of time, just this tiny sliver. We don't understand what's going on. Now, as you back off, I mean, the reason I like looking at history is because it gives you a better perspective, helps you understand some of the things that are happening. But like just now, I've been reading about and listening to Tom Holland and Dominic Sandbrook about the French Revolution. It's really helping me understand some of the things going on in our culture today. But Habakkuk's going much, much bigger. He's saying God is eternal. And if you like, we're here and he's off the edge of the screen. There is no screen, if you like, for God. And so it's this God who we come to. He's holy and he's eternal. And we're not. But also, he has a commitment to his people. Now, the NIV translation says, you will never die, and most other translations do that. But the actual original manuscripts are, we will never die. And I think that that is more accurate. I think there are many other commentators who basically say the same thing. My God, my Holy One, we will not die. So there's this very personal, it's my God, my Holy One, and because of that, we will not die. The Son of God who loved me, says Paul, Galatians 2:20, and gave himself for me. And that is just an absolutely wonderful thing for us to have. In the midst of all that, we know that the judge of all the earth will do right. We know that God is light and in him there is no darkness at all. And I just want you to grasp how brilliant that is. For me, it's such a fabulous image and picture. I've got all these questions, all these doubts, all these fears, and I haven't in my life had those. And if I'm looking at myself in my world at this time, I get stuck. But if I look at God and say, you are from eternity, you are the Holy One, but also you are my God. That is just such a wonderful basis on which to draw comfort. And I hope you do. And tomorrow we'll look at the second part of this verse. God bless you. See you then. Bye. Oh, I'm going to say, here is Only a Holy God by City of Light. Enjoy this.